Well up, good day everyone. Welcome to my YouTube channel. All in all, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to create an Endless Runner game in 1 week. Yeah, that's right, 1 week. We're going to cover through the basic to the advanced level, which includes in-app purchase, game, and getting extra characters and then getting coins. We're going to cover all that just in 1 week. Yeah, I know what you'll be thinking right now, that it's not possible, but I'm gonna show you. Watch it. Now I have a basic scene here. This is my character. I got him from Mixamo. So if you don't have your character, or maybe if you're not good with Blender, you can go to mixamo.com and download your character. Okay, now let's get things started. So I'm gonna create sorry about that. I'm going to create an animator. Now when you click, let me delete this. Okay, let me just delete this. Let's start afresh. Okay, so you are with me. Go to create an animator controller. I didn't want to call it that. Let's call it character controller. Now, when you go to Mixamo, you don't just download characters model, you can also download animations there. Now, you can go there, look at the animations are downloaded. Yeah. I downloaded the idle animation, the jumping up, the running, and the sliding. Okay, that's it. So I'm gonna go back to my game here. Go to my player. Now let's name this to player, so it's gonna be a little bit easier for us. So let me add an animator. Then drag our character controller animator controller to here. That's what you need. Now you have hooked up these two things together. Now go to your downloaded animations and then drag and drop your running animation to here. Okay, now let's test this out. But before that, let's create a platform so it will be easier for us to move, see things. Let's reset the transform. That's perfect. Let's give it 20. Wonderful. Okay. Here's my player. Make sure your root motion is not ticked. If it's ticked, just untick it. Now, if you see our character trying to move, okay, what's happening? Oh, sorry, I really fucked up. I really messed up there. When you import your character from Mixamo, okay, and you're going to use another animation that you imported, it's best. Use now go to that character, go to your character. You see your rig right here. The animation type, change it to humanoid. Yeah, that's another trick you use. You can use one character and then get tons of animations and then use it without having actually going to Blender to write yours. Now you can equally do that to your downloaded animations too, everything. Let them be humanoid. Okay. I think we're all set here. Okay. Yeah. Let's see it move. Is Junior moving? What? Something is wrong. Something is definitely wrong. Something. What's happening? Okay. There. Boom. Now we have started moving. Okay. That's right there. So now let's go write some scripts, our movement scripts. Now go to your, let's go here, create a new C sharp script. Let's call it character motto. Yeah. Now let's open it up. I use Visual Studio Code for my coding. But it doesn't matter, you can use any one you have. You can use normal Visual Studio. Yeah. Now let's start putting down some variables. You're gonna need of course private animator. Now we are going to be moving our character with a Unity character controller. Let's call it control. What do we need again? Okay, let's go with public float speed. Let's just leave it at that for now. Private. Let me add our minimum speed to gauge our speed. Since we are already here, let me just write it out once. It's too hot. Let me just say, let's say it's 5.0. Yeah. Let's also get our maximum speed. Yes, you guessed that right. We're gonna need what are we gonna need again? I'm trying to remember. Okay, we're gonna need the vector 3 move vector. What else do we need again? Okay. Yeah, it's true, we need let's make this public float lane distance. That is the switching of the lane. I think I'm gonna give that 6.0 for now. I hope it's not too big. But let's get another float. What's the velocity? You're gonna be seeing all this. Put. Let's go with our jump force. Since we're not using rigid body, so we're gonna be adding our own gravity too. Jump force, let's give our jump force a value of 12. 12, okay, no. You can always change that, of course. Then, desired lane. And that's, I think, all for now. So, let's get our components. equals to get component character controller. And of course, before you do this, you should know this character controller has to be attached, or rather, before this works, it means you have to attach the character controller to the game object. Same with the animator. That's right. Now we get to the update function. Right now our game is still not doing anything.